So let's see what happens. Let's get our first game in. Going to keep a handful of garbage, but I need a mulligan aggressively for something to do, so I don't need to keep situational stuff there. Something to do, and we're doing all right. Okay, let's see what his turn looks like. This guy's got his one damage in. I'm totally willing to sacrifice now. If it comes up, like, he's just gone. Oh, my bad. Oopsies. Sorry. A stalking wolf. Pass? I will, absolutely. Oh, I can't double trade. Yeah, that's fine. Heal anything 7, draw 1. Okay, that's a really nice card to just get for no reason. I'll take my turn with 5 mana. So we're definitely... let's see. So... not a little unfortunate. We'll just get an attack in to not give him a chance to play something pre-combat. If he wants to take the trade, he can. If not, whatever. And under normal circumstances, I would do my best to up their Zez. So let's see what happens here. He's elusive. If I summon this, he's just going to call it. But if I play it, I'll play it. I might be able to debate him into doing something stupid. We'll see. Like, I have 2 of these, so I'm not necessarily worried, and I do want to take as much value as I can. That Ez is going to be a little bit of a problem, depending on how he built his deck. We got... He's getting Mystic Shots whenever it hits. Kill an ally, then revive it. Okay. Thank you. If I'm summoned... when I'm summoned, draw a unit if an ally died this round. When summoned by an elite... oh. This is rough. I'm going to have an opportunity to do it after combat, so I'm just going to let him do whatever bullshit he wants to do. He's going to pull a hair. Oh, interesting. You do want to take out the Blade Scout. Frostbite an enemy. Interesting. So then what I was normally going to do was let him 1-for-1 it. But now I'll just take this trade where I can... trying to keep track of how much mana he's used, and that Ezreal was coming no matter what. But since an ally died, I will summon this and draw a card. And now Vanguard costs less. It's about kind of timing what they're planning on doing with what I'm planning on doing. And so again, if I play something pre-combat, I'm giving him the opportunity to play something pre-combat. And I'm not sure if I want that or if I want him to take the trades that are on the board. So I'm just going to aggressively attack, not let him get the chance to play something. He'll take an even money trade. I'm deciding now if it's worth it for me to do this or slam the Garen. I think getting Garen down is really important. There's your Ash. Well, see, now things have gotten a little bit crazier. Yeah, let's get the Garen down. So when the Ash attacks, it's gonna stifle Garen, but I'm still gonna kill that Ash on my turn. Cool. That's an alright card, but what do you want me to do? Pre-combat nothing? Ugh. No, this is for next round, I think. I'll have 5 mana. No, I'm... I think I'm okay with this board. I'll do any damage to her. I can't block him. Ugh. It's a waste to do this here. But... like, it feels like that was the right choice for him to make, but he didn't know why it was the right choice. Do I have any other elites I can summon to get some value? No, I'll just play another 3-3. That's going right to Garen. I can't do anything about it. How much mana? No, we'll save that for next round. I like slightly regret not using Swiftwing Challenger. It's unfortunate that I lost Garen, but I'll play this first to get that Ash the f*** out of here. How many spells has he played? 2 targets? Alright, well, that doesn't matter. You're dead. What's gonna do? 1 and 2. And 3. And we'll attack. With a little bit of a trick in my sleeve. Yeah. So I saw that coming the entire time. I just want to see what they think they're gonna do. Like, if he's going to try to put 2 damage on Ez, which would be foolish. Like, just take the 2. It's not going to kill you. This is a trade I have no problem making. What does this do? Frostbite an enemy. Alright, well, my interesting question is, if I shadow shift this, does that character also have Frostbite? Let's find out. It does not. Excellent. That's fair. I have this in my back pocket. I'm trying to think if I need to save an extra energy or put a 2-1 out. I'm putting a 2-1 out to represent don't attack with that idiot. And we'll see what happens from there. He's got nothing. I'm winning in card advantage, and I'm winning in all conceivable ways except board state, and that's based on whether or not this Ash can do anything. If you play anything pre-combat, I'm going to end you. Like, do not do that. Okay, cool. I can't block him. Ugh. He played that in combat to kill my 2-1. Which is a weird... like, if you were going to do that, you should have attacked with him too. Because that was the trade. But, alright. I guess you're 4 of 8? Or is that the 3 of 8? Yeah, it's 4 of 8. Alright. Well. I do want a 2 mana 5-5. With tough. Like, a 5 mana 8-8 was cool, but a 2 mana 5-5 is... like, I'm winning this going wide. I'm not winning this going, like, tall. So I want to make sure that I'm getting all these chip shots. What is that, hitting him? Okay. Sure. I will also play 2 mana 5-5. Oh, it was elite, too? Man, I should pay attention. I didn't even know that was going to give me value next turn. I will take my turn. Unfortunate that I lost Garen this early. We're gonna... yeah, I'll totally play stuff pre-combat. Like, it's okay. Deal 4 damage to an enemy unit. Otherwise frostbite. Okay. That was one turn of not worrying. Give an ally challenger this round. Give you challenger. We're killing Ez, and we're killing this guy right now. You have nothing, and you know it. Wait, come on. Deal two? Okay. Sure. That was not the correct target. We're gonna squeeze in. Like, we're gonna get 1 point of damage in. What? Okay. Like, he's doing all he can to save the Ez, which is slightly unfortunate. Do I have enough to do both of these? No. That Ez is going to be a problem. That Ez is going to flip, but I don't think it's going to matter. I have too much damage coming in every turn, and he doesn't have enough value in his hand. Like, I think if this comes to a shootout, I've gotten him. I'll take one, thank you. This is a slow spell. So I know he's about... I know that's a Mystic Shot. I don't know what the other card is, and I know if I do that... Alright, I'll play this. That Mystic Shot can only kill one person. What's that? Deal two damage to enemy Nexus. He has to use the Mystic Shot, so I don't want to give him a target from hand. I'll pass. Okay. Now. Okay, that Ez flipped. It's now... When you cast a spell, deal 2 damage. Alright, well... We're gonna go back to full health and draw a card. Yeah, there's no card I could draw on turn one that I would play first. So we're just gonna come crashing in combat, not letting him get a chance to put another blocker on the board. Sure, that's a cleanup shot for Ez. That guy's gonna chump block probably one of the fives. He might be under the impression that this is a race, but he's about to get cracked for 10. And it's going to have to be a bigger turn for him. Now he has one card in hand. It is a creature. I'm going to play literally everything. Like, yeah, that dies to Ez, but either one or the other. You know, like, this dies to Ez right now. This dies to Ez, and this dies to Ez. Or this might not. I think it's... Tough is... All sources. Okay, so these two cards die to Ez, so I might as well make sure that when that Ez attacks, I'm not going to worry. Part of me is saying I should block this. Shuffle 4 copies of the supported ally in your deck. So he's going to have 4 copies of Ez. Do I even want to take a trade? Yeah, I'll split the difference. Okay. I have no actions. Feel free to do whatever you like. Shoot. Pass. That shot is probably almost definitely going here. Like, yeah. Okay. I mean, you're still dead, right? Like, you're still Dobbs. Oh, you got it, dude. I'll put another character in. The fact he hasn't conceded yet, I think he's assuming that I don't know I can attack on my turn. Interesting choice. Ah, the rubs. Ah, unfortunate. So yeah, you saw what he was doing, but you saw the reason I had control of that game from start to finish was, you know, with some lucky RNG, I controlled the board the entire time. I never felt behind. I knew he was trying to set up some kind of great endgame strategy of Ezzing and then plopping me down. What he wasn't able to do was build a threatening enough board in the early game to force me to either block and lose control or do enough chip damage to justify it. So, like, that's kind of insightful of, like, the difference between draft formats like this, like limited formats, and constructed formats. In constructed formats, you kind of have an understanding of what the meta is and what people are going to do. I'm not saying I'm going to go all the way on this, but I'm pretty confident that my build just has so many thick bodies and so much opportunity to win the board that unless something goes completely out of hand or I'm fighting against somebody who ripped Jesus out of his pools, I'm probably going to do fairly well with this. And I'll get another fight in real quick. I think I have enough time for one more.